Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen, and welcome to this month's Commander's Corner. It's August 1st, 2013, and with me on the show today is the new face of Yokosuka. He's going to be relieving me here shortly, Captain David Glenister, and we're going to talk with him here in a couple minutes. First of all, let me go through some announcements here and some things that are going on around CFAY. This Saturday, August 3rd, is a big day for us. It's the Friendship Festival. Last year, we had 41,000 people come on the base. We're looking probably around those same numbers this year. Gates open at 10 a.m., and it runs till 2100 that evening. There will be fireworks from the city. Weather's looking good for us that day. Maybe a little hot, so make sure you're hydrating. But lots of people going to be on the base on Saturday, so it should be a good time. Lots of food to buy. We're going to have some entertainment. So come on out and get to know some of the community and those in the host country that we live in that are going to come see us that day. On August 7th, the Chapel of Hope is going to be starting a grief loss support group, and it's going to be every Wednesday from 1 to 3 p.m. for about 6 weeks. So that's something you can sign up if you're interested for. I got an announcement about our veterinary clinic. The facility is going to be closed for appointments and certificates and exams due to shortages. The counter sales will remain open. And there's two sets of dates that this is going to be affected by, August 5th through the 9th and August 26th through September 5th. So during those time frames, the veterinary clinic will not be available for those. Anybody who has a pet here in the country, it's a good idea that you get to know a vet off base as well. So when we get the shortages or something like this happen, in case you get an emergency or you get in a bind and need to get a health certificate, that's a good idea to have a relationship with a vet off the base also. All right, August 12th through 16th is going to be Vacation Bible School. It's going to be called Kingdom Rock this year. It's from 9 a.m. to 12:15, and they're still taking volunteers. If you're interested in helping out with Vacation Bible School, you can go to the Chapel of Hope or email them or get hold of the Facebook page. I'm sure they can find something for you to help them out with. On August 17th, up at Nagishi in the housing area there, the Bonadori is a go. We will be doing the Bonadori up at Nagishi on August 17th. So all those who like to go do the bond dance, you know, this way and that way and everything, you can go up there and either watch it or get off your duffs and dance with it a little bit yourself. But it's another good time, another open base event. Usually somewhere between 5,000 to 6,000 people come on the housing area when that happens. Oh, sorry, kiddies. Your summer vacation's almost over. You should be going out and getting school supplies now. First day of school for grades 1 through 12 is August 26th. So that one's coming up here real soon. So make sure you're starting to get ready for school. If you're a kindergartner, you don't have to go. You don't start until the 4th of September. And first day of school for sure start is the 12th of September. Previously announced that we're going to have the MCPON coming in July. That got moved. We are still expecting the MCPON to come and hold an all-hands call. Don't have the date locked down yet, but expect that sometime in September. So you will get a chance to see the MCPON this year still. Some PWD projects going on, you might have noticed. The renovating and expanding the beauty and optical shop over at the NEX. That's a rather long project. It's going to take a while. It's not going to get done until around the end of November, so they're talking like 25 November for that project to be complete. So if you're just wondering what's going on over there. The Benny Decker floor stage got replaced earlier this year. We're doing the Fleet Theater now. That is on track. The Fleet Theater should be ready to open back up probably late September, early October as they work on the stage over there. And for all you softball and baseball players, there's a project coming up starting October 3rd. The main softball field is going to start getting artificial turf. It should be ready by the baseball season next spring. So you're not going to be able to use the excuse anymore, guys, that the ball hit a hole and took a bad bounce. Is that why you didn't field it? All right, so they're going to be putting artificial turf over at the main field. And I got word from NEX that the IHOP has been approved. That's the International House of Pancakes Express. It's going to be going over in the main food court. Probably won't be open to serve its first pancake or waffle till the early next year. But the contract's approved. They got to get the equipment in and start getting everything put in place. It's going to go in where the A&W and the fish place is right now. But you're going to have another place where you can pick up some breakfast food here on the base here real soon. Some MWR events coming up. On the 4th of August is the Liberty Kanazaka Lighthouse Bicycle Ride. So if you're interested in that, it's at 11 o'clock on the 4th. And the Liberty Program Outreach. I want to push this 7 August over at the Galley from 1100 to 1245. Good chance for some single sailors to come over and find out some things that are going on and some alternatives and things you can keep yourself occupied with. Captain's Cup Sports. We're still out there to dethrone Subgroup 7, everybody, so let's get your teams together. On 12 August, there's a tennis tournament, and on 17 August, there's a track meet. The track meet will be held down at Ikego, so get your fleet of foot out there, and let's run all over Subgroup 7 this year. What do you say? And then, speaking of running, on the 14th of August is the Midsummer Night Fun Run. That starts at 1900 over at Purdy Gym. You can go over there and run in the evening. I'm not sure if fun and run goes together very well for some people, but still, you can go over there and give it a shot. One more thing I want to put out here before I start talking to our special guest here in my relief is, remember, during the critical days of summer, the NEX and the Exchange new car sales offer a free ride program. So if you've had too much of the ignorant oil, you can get yourself a free ride to anywhere on the Yokosuka-based home or to either of the three train stations. That's Yokosuka Chua, the Shiori, or the JR station. So that, along with the designated driver programs at the clubs, there's no excuse to drink and drive around here on CFAY. All right, now to the new face of Yokosuka here to my left. This is Captain David Glenister. Him and his family just got here a few days ago. We're in the midst of turnover. Next week, on August the 8th, we're going to be having our change of command, and he's going to take the reins from me. I understand you're no stranger to Yokosuka, though, correct?
This is not my first tour here. I've visited Yokosuka on almost every ship I've been on. I was assigned to 7th Fleet Staff from 2004 to 2006. So my family saw a lot of Japan at that time. I was gone probably 6 months of the year. I was in a planned shop job, but no, I am no stranger to Yokosuka. Sometimes the commands change, the buildings rarely do, so it doesn't look too much different from that.
Do I understand correctly, one of your children was actually born here?
One of them was born here, born and baptized here. My younger son, Brendan, was born at Naval Hospital Yokosuka in January of 2005.
All right, and you lived in Ikego when you
I did live in Ikego. Shout out to 83 Nico Tower, all those folks living there. Yeah, forgive me for all those holes in the walls.
Oh, okay, so that was you.
That was me.
All right, now we know where that came from. All right, cool. And you mentioned you got two children. What are they?
I do. Aiden is 12 and Brendan is 8, so I'll have one in the middle school and one in the elementary school.
All right, cool. I bet they're all excited and looking forward to it.
They are. We took a walk around the base. Like I said, my young son Brendan wanted to see where he was born, so we went to Seattle's Best there in the Naval Hospital and have been getting familiar with the base, and they're looking forward to a good school year and meeting a lot of folks and enjoying Japan.
All right, cool. Sounds great to me. You had command of a ship at one time, too, right?
I did. I actually have had command of a mine hunter out of Texas as an O4, USS Falcon, and also USS Rents out of San Diego. That was my last command, part of Nimitz Strike Group. Actually passed through Japan, went to Sasebo, and also Takamatsu, which is a smaller and a shallower draft port here in Japan.
And where'd you just escape from? Where'd you just come from?
Yes, I was in exile from the Navy for the last 3 years as part of the joint staff. And recently come from the J-8, the money guys, or lack of money guys, depending on your point of view.
Right.
So good to be outside of the Puzzle Palace,
yeah,
five-sided
so.
Foxhole, and out here back with the fleet. So
I
it's
bet.
Great to be
I bet
here.
You're glad to be out of that one
very
for
much.
A little while. So, but again, on 8th of August, we're doing a ceremony over at C2 building. Captain Dave Glenister is going to be taking over. He's going to be your new face of Yokosuka around here. I'm sure he's going to do a great job, and so get used to seeing his pearly whites around the base now instead of mine here before much longer. You know, many times I have to talk about negative stuff that sailors have done, especially if it involves ignorant oil or things of sexual assault, and bad stuff gets in the papers. But it's really cool that I get to do a good shout-out here. And this shout-out goes to BU-1 Wells and MMC McKinney, who a couple weekends ago, they were at Kamakura Beach surfing, and they noticed that two young girls were basically drowning and trying to signal for help. And these sailors went out and they rescued these two women. The one was actually coughing up seawater as they were trying to get her back to the beach. So there's a good chance that these two sailors saved at least one of the women's lives and maybe both of them. So that's something that doesn't wind up in the news often enough. Are sailors out there doing good things? Sailors are the solution, and too often we hear too much about the negative, but there's a positive. And if you know either one of these sailors or if you run across them, please give them a big attaboy and pat them on the back. Okay, I've as mentioned a couple times already in the show, I'm coming up on the end of my tour. I've been here now for a little over three years, and it's time for me to say farewell to CFAY. It's been a great tour. It's been an honor to serve this community. We've had some rough times, like in 2011 with the earthquake and the tsunami. We're going not through the smoothest of times now with the budget constraints and sequestration, and things are changing. But we always get through it. We're a good team here, and I know you'll continue it. So I had to come up with a final trivia question because I always had the trivia questions. So I decided to focus it on CFAY itself. All right, there's been a lot of commanders at CFAY, both Japanese and then after 1945 on the U.S. side. What Japanese officer commanded CFAY the longest, and what U.S. officer commanded CFAY the longest? Hint, it's not me. Have a great day, CFAY.